Hello friends, here in this video we will see problem on design of bolts, and here the case is that the load is parallel to the bolt axis. Here we have a question. A bracket as shown in figure diagram is given, supports a load of 30 kN. Determine the size of bolts. If the maximum allowable tensile stress in the bolt material is 60 MPa, the distances are L1 is 80 mm, L2 250 mm and capital L is 500 mm. So this is the question which we have. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. So let us get started. In data, first I will write down the type of the problem. And here the type is load is parallel to bolt axis. Next, a bracket as shown in figure supports a load of 30 kN. Value of this load W, this is given as 30 kN, so I'll write it down. W is equal to 30 kN. It is 30 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Determine the size of bolts. Size of bolts mean, here we have to calculate how much will be the core diameter or the minimum diameter of the bolt, and how much would be the outer or nominal diameter. If the maximum allowable tensile stress in the bolt material is 60 MPa. For the bolts, the tensile stress is given as 60 MPa. So sigma t is 60 Newton per mm square. Then the distances are L1 is 80 mm, L2 is 250 mm, capital L. So I'll write it L1 80 mm, L2 250 mm, capital L 500 mm. So these distances are expressed in the diagram. This section 1 or center line 1 which has bolt here. Now the distance of the bolt axis 1, it is L1 from this fixed edge. Next, for the bolt axis 2, the distance from the fixed edge is 250 mm. And the distance between the fixed edge and the load, that is capital L, is equal to 500 mm. So all these values are given in the problem. Now, how to solve this question? First of all, when the load is acting, there are chances that there would be bolts here. In center line 1, I will assume there are two bolts in the same line having same distance L1. At the same location there would be two bolts. Next, similarly at L2 distance there would be two bolts. So in total there are four bolts, and when the load is acting, this load would be shared by each of the four bolts, and this case is called as primary tensile load. So in the solution part, I'll start with this. In solution, I'll say that since the total load W is shared equally by all the bolts, so therefore primary tensile load W suffix T1, it will be equal to W by N. So therefore WT1 will be equal to, W is given as 30 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Here I'll assume N, which is the number of bolts, as 4. So from this I will be getting WT1. My answer is 7.5 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. This I will keep it as equation number 1. Next, after getting the value of primary tensile load, primary tensile load will be acting on all the four bolts having the same value, that is 30 divided by 4 into the number of bolts. Now, the first effect which I have shown, that when the load is acting, this bracket will get pulled down, and when the bracket is being pulled down, all the four bolts, they would be stretched and failing. So this was primary tensile load. Now, because of secondary tensile load, what can happen is that when the load is acting, suppose all the bolts, they are not stretched equally. Some of the bolts are stretched unequally, that is the bolts which are closer to point A, which is the tilting edge. These bolts are far away from the load, so they would be stretching less, whereas the bolts which are closer to the load, they would be stretching more. So because of this unequal stretching, what can happen, this bracket, it can tilt, and when it is tilting, the bolts, they are subjected to tension and they would be failing because of secondary tension. So here I'll say that since bolts may also fail due to secondary tensile load, so therefore let small w be load per unit distance, it will be in terms of Newton per mm. Now if we can see in the diagram, as I have explained, the bolts which are closer to the load, that is bolts at distance L2, they will be heavily loaded compared to the bolts at L1, because at L1 the bolts are far away from the load, at L2 they are closer to the load. So we would be designing the bolts which are heavily loaded. Once we design these bolts, then it will even be safe at section L1. So here I'll say that therefore secondary tensile load on bolts at L2 distance that secondary tensile load is because bolts which are closer to the load are heavily loaded. So therefore the secondary tensile load will be WT2 is equal to small w, that is the intensity of load per unit distance, multiplied by, now we know the distance where the load will be maximum, that is L2. So therefore WT2, it is equal to small w, the value we can find it out. Now small w will be capital W into L upon 2 into L1 square plus L2 square, and here it is into L2. So therefore if I put the values, WT2 will be equal to capital W, it is 30 into 10 raised to 3, capital L was 500 upon 2 into L1, it was 80, L2 250 multiplied by L2, which was again 250. So first I'll get this value and therefore I'll write it. Now here secondary tensile load, I have written this value into 250, so I'll get this as, therefore W suffix T2 is equal to, I am getting it as 108.85 multiplied by L2 is 250. So therefore my final answer of secondary tensile load, it comes out to be 27.21 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Now, in equation number 1, we were getting primary tensile load. This was 7.5 10 raised to 3 Newton. In equation 2, we have got secondary tensile load. We can add both the values to get the total tensile load. So therefore, total tensile load W suffix T is equal to WT1 plus WT2. So therefore, WT1 is 7.5 into 10 raised to 3 plus WT2 27.21 into 10 raised to 3. So therefore, the total tensile load value will be equal to, my answer is 34.71 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Now, after getting the value of total tensile load, we can say that since the total tensile load will be acting at the minimum area of thread or threaded section in bolts, since the total tensile load would be acting at minimum area, and minimum area is the in the threaded section the core area. So after this I'll say that therefore total tensile load will be equal to area multiplied by tensile stress. Now if I can explain this with a diagram, here this is a threaded section, because for bolts the thread section are the weakest, so I am not drawing the portion which is ahead, only the threaded section. Now in this threaded section, here there is a minimum diameter which is called as the core diameter. And this core diameter is the location where the threads will fail. So if we look at this, the area will be in the form of a circle. This is the failing area, or we can say resisting area. So therefore total tensile load is equal to pi by 4 into dc square multiplied by sigma t. Here I'll go on putting the values. 34.71 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to pi by 4 dc square. And sigma t value was given in the question. It was 60 Newton per mm square into 60. Now, therefore, here we want to calculate DC, that is the core diameter. So we have to shift all terms on one side. So therefore, DC square will be equal to 34.71 into 10 raised to 3. 4 goes on to the other side. So multiplied by 4 divided by pi into 60, you will be getting an answer. And now if I take the square root of that answer, I would be getting the value of DC. So DC comes out to be 27.14 mm. This will be the first answer. And after getting DC, I can say that therefore DO, nominal diameter, is DC divided by 0.84. This is an empirical relation which we can use to calculate the maximum diameter in a thread. So therefore DO will be equal to DC, that is 27.14 divided by 0.84. So therefore DO will be, my answer is 32.3 mm, means the outer diameter of the threads, they are 32.3 mm, but we can round off this value and the next higher value is 33. So M33 is the size of the bolt. So I'll say that therefore selecting M33, which is the standard size of bolt, size of coarse series threads. So here we would be selecting M33 bolts. And if we look into this question, they were telling us to calculate the DC, core diameter and nominal diameter and design the bolt. And here we have designed the bolt for the case in which load was parallel to bolt axis.